Hello, ladies and gentlemen, Canadian Duke here, back with another NBA 2K15 All-Sim My GM mode as the Minnesota Timberwolves, guys, alright? So, last episode on Friday, we went through, the rotation, made a couple trades, we traded for Scola, and Landry, I think? Yeah, that sounds right. Oh my god, I fall asleep on you guys. But that is the rotation. Those are the minutes for everybody. Ben only is 7. He's going to need to pick up a slack. He needs to pick up a slack, basically. But that's the rotation that we're going to start off this year, guys. I think we're kind of go with the rebuild. But we have some good guys who can come up. We can always improve, though. Like, we always draft a good power forward or even the shooting guard. Who knows? Point guard, we're going with Rubio. And Wiggins, we're set at small forward. So, that's that. I have been playing some. I have my own season going with the Raptors, just kind of screwing around with to get to know this, and it's actually pretty in depth. I'll be showing you guys some of the features in this. That is actually pretty crazy, some of the stuff they've added. So I don't know what's going on in here, but there's something important that we have to go take care of. Oh, okay. Trainer Rubio is playable injury, strained quad. Okay. Now, usually I know how I just go with a make playthrough. Now it actually affects the rating a lot more, and it'll affect the morale if make him play through it, but he's only day-to-day, so I'll make him play through it. He'll be fine. See, he puts his morale down by 1. Press interview now. As a first-time NBA general manager, what are you hoping to accomplish here with the Minnesota Timberwolves? Multiple championships, constantly improve, wait and see. I want multiple championships, man. I'll be frank. I didn't come here to win just one championship. Not 2, not 3, not 4, not 5, not 6, not 7. Not 8, not 9, not 10, not 11, not 12, not 13, not 14, not 15, not 16. Please tell me this is over. Not 17, not 18, not 19. Yeah, that's right, I want 20. I immediately regret this answer. This is a terrible answer. But I'm sure everybody will love that. Okay, owner hated that. I don't know why he doesn't want to win championships. But the reporter liked that, so that's actually good to keep him happy because they'll ask you some real asshole questions. But staff didn't like that, but opposing GMs like that, all players like that. I don't know why they like that so much, but whatever. Now I'm guessing somebody got hurt or something. Oh, Rubio's all good. Adjust rotations, all good. Let's go, let's go! Okay, so we won that. I don't even know what our record's looking like right now. Lost, won, lost, won, lost. I bet you're probably around like a 500 team right now. JJ Bird has a playable injury, sprained elbow. Yeah, you can play through it, tough kid. But I'm going to make most people play through the injury unless it's like a long-term playable injury, then maybe I'll just cut down my minutes, or if it's a starter. And it's a big one if it's not day-to-day. Hey, Emperor Ron, what? Oh, med scout. I was like, hey, Emperor Ronaldo, it's time for me to set up the first scouting trips. Which prospects? I'll let him always handle that. It just saves me some work. Lil Wine, I really trust your judgment on these matters. I feel confident that you can take care of all the scouting decisions going forward. Thanks, Duke. It's great working with someone that trusts me ability. I won't let you down. You fucking better not. I swear to God, I'll cut you loose. We won there against the Mavs, which is nice. I will fucking destroy you if you disappoint me. Trainer, I have some fantastic news. JJ Bria is all good. Perfect. Everybody's in the pluses, though. They're gaining overall, so that's good. Ooh, Philly's giving us a call. What kind of trade do you want to make, Philly? Please tell me you want to get rid of... Oh, no. We're going to throw Roten and Elliot Williams for Levine and Budinger. That is a good... No. Well, let me look at this for a second. Budinger's a bust. Oh, that would save me some cap. But I really do like Levine. I mean, but Roten can't be that bad. Let's look at the players and see how they're doing this year. View player card. Where am I going? So he's putting up 6 points a game, 3 rebounds. Okay, that's nice. Bunger probably not doing anything. Yeah, I didn't think so. What about these guys? Okay, that's okay. That's pretty good. He's put up some good minutes. I really don't want to give up Levine, though, is the thing. I really like Levine. Oh, this is killing me here. But then I do have that other point guard. What's his name? No, I don't have another point guard. I thought I did. I could use another shooting guard. Oh, but then I wouldn't have another point guard. No, I'm not gonna make that. I have two now. Yeah, no. Check that. He's a shooting guard, and I think runs a small forward. And no, he's a point guard. No, I can't. I can't. I don't want to give up Levine yet. He's young. He's gonna be good. I bet you. Which of your team are you currently the most pleased with? What am I most pleased with? I'm gonna say depth. The reporter, what do you want, reporter? No matter what I answer, you're gonna get mad at me, so I really don't give a fuck. Lost to the Knicks there. Hey, Duke, I saw you bring your attention that it doesn't feel pushing guys hard enough in practice. Oh yeah, that's another thing you can do. You can, I'll show you this real quick. You can like see what you want to do with the physical aptitudes, if you want to go speed, lateral quickness, blah blah blah. Same with tactical and fundamental. Training intensity, I usually keep that medium because everyone seems a bitch no matter what. But here, I like to screw with around. I usually take tactical down, maybe a lot in fundamental just because it's a young team. Maybe we'll go 33 in physical. Yeah, let's go with that. Tactical 29. Let's go with that. I mean, it won't make a huge difference, but it might make a bit. On the right side, yeah, I see the overall workload is high. So, yeah, whatever. That seems okay. We want it high, medium or high. I don't want it too crazy though. If you start to lose games, maybe I'll push it high. But oh, that's two blowouts. Oh, great, that's two blowouts back to back. Do you have any plans to get your team back on track? Trade is coming. I'm gonna say we're fine. I didn't really have anything to say. It's just two games. Doesn't mean anything at all. Public opinion went down, and trust. Well, okay, nobody liked that. But I'm not throwing my team under the bus and saying I'm gonna trade somebody. Maybe I should have said that. I don't know. Pekovic for Gasol. What? This is such a weird trade. Like, that's such a good trade for us and terrible for them. I don't know why they would offer us that. I mean, Gasol is a 1-year deal, yeah. But he's a way better center. Yeah, oh my god, yeah. Yes, I can't accept this quick enough. Wow, that was a good deal. Never had such a good deal offered to me. Nice thing I found with this is actually there's fair deals and that other GMs actually negotiate with you. So let's put the shit in. Dang, we'll put in Gasol. And then Carter's gonna go in here. Bump him up. Where are we gonna put him? Let's swap there. Oh my god, what am I doing? Actually no, I should leave Brewer up because Brewer's gonna get bitchy if we put his minutes down too much. But then Carter's gonna get mad no matter what. Who am I kidding? Fuck. Yeah, fuck Brewer. I really get Brewer mad. Take Brewer down to 13. Landry down to 15. Carter up to 20. Keep him trying. Try and keep him happy at least. Okay, that looks good. That looks good. I have to give. Oh fuck, I forgot all about. Hey you, Gasol. Forgot you need minutes. Fuck Scola. Now we'll give Deng some minutes. Yeah. Yeah. Then Muhammad can stay on the 13th and not get any minutes. That should be okay, I think. Oh, we have one more minute. Let's give it to Scola. No, we'll give it to Gasol, who am I kidding? So yeah, that's good, I guess. That was a pretty good trade. Fans love your recent acquisition of Marc Gasol. Where do you see him slotting in with the team? Team leader, well, good starter. I mean, he is a team leader, but he's a good starter, I guess, because he's starting. Obviously, he's a great player and an instant starter. I think he'll fit right in with this roster and help us do some damage in the playoffs. Playoffs? We talking about playoffs? That was really bad. I apologize for that. Brooklyn's giving us a ring. What do you guys want to do now? Oh, the loading times seem pretty long in this, so they want to do so it's Jarrett Jack, the DUI king, crushing beers and driving over queers. That's patent pending for Jarrett Jack, actually. Not really, but so Dang Rubio for Plumlee and Jack. Not happening, not feeling that at all. Just I'm fine at center. We don't need a center, we have Gasol. And I'd rather not put Jack in at point guard. Toronto's giving us a call. That automatically makes them. Oh, never mind. I was expecting better. Okay, let me put this straight. You want our first round pick And Kevin Margaret, who's 2.5 stars, for Louis Williams, that's also 2.5 stars. If it was Martin for Williams, I still say no. So there is no way I'm doing that. I am insulted by you, sir. Insulted. Wow, that hurts me. Orlando, what do you want? Want to give us a star? Oh, wait, you have none. Oh, you want Wiggins? Not happening. You want me to give Wiggins and Hummel for Tobias Harris in a first. Now, that first would be nice, but I can't give up Wiggins. That ain't happening. I'd feel too bad. So moving on, we're almost at the end of the month. But the head coach, Flip Saunders, wants to talk to us about our next opponent. Nah, I ain't changing shit. I'm too lazy. And there we go. That, see, now social media is just a bunch of stupid shit. Oh, Harden's out for 6 to 8 weeks with a broken leg. I usually just leave the stuff. It does collect up, though, after a while. So here you can see if everyone's happy or what's going on. Marc Gasol will have talked about lowering the training intensity. No, I won't even talk to you about that. If you sometimes you talk to them. Oh, okay, see, I'll do this one. He's upset that we haven't extended his contract yet. But you watch this now. I'll just show you guys. Hey, Duke, I'm absolutely livid that I haven't been approached yet about having my contract extended. I'm loyal to this team and not feeling the loyalty in return. So I can say, pump him up pitch or get your back, but that costs points. And I can decline. I should be like, you know what, fuck, we didn't want you on this team, blah, blah, blah. I can be like, hey, you know what, I don't want you back, but I really appreciate what you're doing. And I can be like, oh, hey, I go sign your extension right now, which I'm going to do because I do want to keep her at. So I promise you an extension. Hey, JJ, I'm really sorry we've been feeling like loyalty isn't being reciprocated. We want you on this team, and I promise an extension done with you within the next week. He says, all right, well, let me know when you want to talk about a new contract. Well, how about right now? Let's go do that. Contract extensions actually doesn't mean to do it, so we can do Gasol, who's undecided. Rubio's ineligible, probably because he has a... actually, that sucks, but Scola's ineligible, but Barea... Yeah, Barea's the only one we can sign. Good veteran, leader in the locker room. Good backup point guard. He wants 2 years at six. Okay, that's actually fair. But I'm a cheap son of a bitch. So that's off from 5-5 to start. Oh, he accepted it. Okay, that was awfully easy. Alright, so team overview here, guys. We are 6-9 on the season. An okay start. I mean, not terrible, not great. Would prefer to be better. We're bottom of our division. But hey, it's a rebuild team. It's a young team. Let's go look at stats real quick, too. See how the team is... Nope, that's wrong. Player stats. So Gasol's leading us in points per game. And then Martin. Then Carter. Off the bench, I guess. Actually, let's see how he's doing. This is cool. You can see season how he did home and on the road. In wins and losses. Per month. Okay, that wouldn't help us out. Actually... Oh, there's a way you can see, like, each, there it is, each game. I don't know when he came over here, but he's been doing well. Oh my god, he's doing really well off the bench. I don't know many games, but still. I'm guessing that wouldn't be it all. Saying, like, that many. Still off the bench. Okay, be right here, it's 20 minutes. Yeah, 10-10. Nah, that's still solid off the bench. I appreciate that. Our boy, Andrew Wiggins, up to a 79 now. Doing all right, it looks like. Okay. 10 points a game, 5 rebounds, an assist and a half, and Scola with 10 points, 7 rebounds a game. That's what we expected. Him and Rubio putting up 8 assists a game, 10 points, 4 rebounds. He's a really all-around player, to be honest. And then Brie off the bench, still putting up 7, so is Landry putting up 6, and so is Brewer. Pretty much identical stats, to be honest with you. That's pretty interesting. I was just looking at something there. Levine's still putting up 5 off the bench. Ben's putting up 3, almost 2 rebounds. That's nice. And, ooh, Dang is putting up 3.5, same amount of points. Bennett, you better step up your game, man. Just saying. Just saying. You got a big contract and you ain't playing well. I'm not going to give up on you, but yeah, step it up, kiddo. And then Hummels hasn't played a game, neither has Muhammad. I don't want to be racist, but it's I'm not playing him not because his name is Muhammad. I'm just putting that out there. League leaders, Carmelo is leading, then LeBron, and then Durant. Usually Durant, just saying, is the one who leads the league in scoring, from what I've noticed. And Love's right there, too. That's interesting. Actually, let's look at who's doing the best rebounds per game. Al Jefferson, yeah, I saw that coming. Drummond, Griffin, best assists. Rubio's in. Rubio's number five. Just saying. Paul's putting up the most assists. Steals. Yeah, Paul. Yeah, I guess that's it, guys. That's it for this episode. I'm going to wrap her up here. I hope you guys enjoyed. Click the like button if you did. And subscribe if you guys want to see more. Have an awesome day, and peace out.